Any simple everyday dish could be elevated into something more interesting and even good enough for special occasion with a little effort and a little know-how.
I'm going to show you a few little tweaks to make a simple chicken and tomato stew into something more special. We are cooking here chakhokbili, chicken-styled Georgian way. All the ingredients are listed in the description to this video.
I always try to use at least free-range chicken or organic, and it works out more economical if I buy the whole bird and then I cut it into pieces myself, into portions. Chicken is washed and just about covered with water, and I put it now to cook for 15-20 minutes. We will achieve two things here. First of all, the excess of fat will go out of chicken, and we will get nice stock, which later on I can skim of fat totally and throw it. And the other thing, it will be much easier to cut chicken in portions.
Makes total sense, and the stew still will be very nice once we finish with it.
So as the chicken is cooking, we're not wasting any time. We quickly make onion and tomato sauce for it. If I'm making this dish for special occasion, I will buy most probably chicken thighs, free range or organic. I will leave skin on. I would start with frying them first from both sides, fry slightly. Then I would add onions to it and fry it all together, and so on, so on. Then I would add my tomatoes, and a few people eating this dish, part of a bigger table, it's okay. But if I'm cooking for every day, just for two of us, I don't want this excess of fat, and I want to have my stock, which I would use for a soup, or maybe I will cook rice in it, or I can freeze this stock for later on. So I want onion to get some color, but not being brown, without getting brown.
By all means, use fresh tomatoes here.
Tomatoes go in, increase the heat here, bring it to the boil, cover with the lid. So yeah, I would use, say, about for this amount, probably 5-6 those largish tomatoes, which they sell on a vine. Those are semi-decent.
The sauce is a bit on the dry side, so I'm adding some water.
No, I would say a third of that tin. Original tin, and rinsing it at the same time. So we chopped onions in quite large pieces. I like to see onions in the final sauce. Okay, meanwhile, I think our chicken, maybe 5 minutes on its back as well. Right, chicken had enough. So I'll take it out. We don't want to cook it. I want to let it cool, and then I will very easily cut it two pieces and put to our tomato sauce. I forgot to add at the time a pepper paste, which is excellent ingredient. It's just like tomato paste, but it's made out of peppers. So, and I really should have treated it as a tomato paste and fry it a little bit with the onions first, but doesn't matter. Let's add a big tablespoon of it. To make the sauce a bit more sort of kind of rich and interesting. Right, good. But I get it from a specialist shop. Excellent ingredient. I use it in so many things. Pepper paste. Ingredients is just literally, it's not hot or anything. Mild red peppers, literally salt. So yeah, we have our little shallots here. I'm going to send them to the pan whole as they are, and I want to see them whole at the end, just for a little extra interest.
And they taste very sweet too.
Into the sauce. How is it doing? So our chicken is cool enough to handle. So we're chopping off my new kitchen scissors. Testing them at the same time, they are fine. So it's much more easier if you hit the correct spot, of course, to join chicken now, literally with good chicken scissors. So the peppers we chop in a kind of largish streaks. Those little cherry tomatoes whole as they are very soon after I've put chicken in.
Like shallots, they will remain whole in the sauce at the end, which will make it look nice.
Some Aleppo chili flakes, which I, as of recent, one of my favorite condiments. Black basil from Armenia. Black purple kind of beautiful herb, which is I actually treasure it and get it from Armenia. It looks very pretty, you know, on the stews, and it's excellent flavoring. Fresh coriander. Fresh coriander would be excellent here, would be very authentic actually. Some sort of a little bit of heat of your choice, or add a black pepper maybe or something. Now I'm adding a Georgian spice, which is absolutely mild, it's just aromatic. If I won't have khmeli suneli, this Georgian garam masala, I would simply add a dry coriander, a bit pinch of mild curry, or you can add cumin or a bit of cinnamon, or cinnamon and cumin, whatever you fancy to make it more interesting. So that's the beauty of those stews. You can, within a reason, you can sort of play around with the spices and make them to your taste and make them different, slightly different every time. The stew is cooking on low now. It's not too thick, not too runny, just as I like it. Normally I will simply just chuck those peppers in, sort of halfway through at some point. If I want to make it a little bit more special, I will fry them separately and add them at the very end. So especially yellow pepper is going to look very pretty. So at the end I've added only half of my peppers. I think it's going to be too much. So if you just take a half of that red pepper and half of that small yellow pepper.
Adjust the seasoning as you go.
Peppers are done. That looks very pretty. Oniony and tomatoey. This is what we wanted. We were aiming liberally. Garlic, 5, 6, 7 cloves, whatever you fancy. On very low, it's virtually done. So all what is left to do is put this handful of garlic in.
The whole sauce is quite chunky. I chop garlic in quite large pieces too.
To do last little tweak, we're going to add this handful of walnuts, which I'm going to process to the fine sort of fine crumbs. And I will add it literally 1 minute before I will switch off, the very last moment. And so we did garlic. Garlic we're going to cook maybe for 2-3 minutes only. Okay, so we put our walnuts here. I learned this little trick from my mother-in-law. This is the ultimate Georgian ingredient, of course. To make the whole thing more luxurious, I would say. Because nuts were always a big luxury and still are, actually. Super. The way my mom and grandma used to cook, it's quite soupy, on the soupy side. So you have lots of sauce to mop it with bread. Fluffy white bread, like a ciabatta. And the best way to eat it, just mopping it with bread, kind of with your hands. I wish I have a fluffy bread though. Of course, it's better if it stand a little bit, but... Wait. Who needs fork here? I wasn't going to eat actually, but I think I will. It's very nice.